Taurus, welcome to my channel. This is going to be a look at the messages from your spiritual team at this moment. Any information that you may be looking for will be in the description. And if you want to see future readings from me, make sure that you subscribe so you never miss a beat. All right, let's see. Let's start off with this deck. So we have new and supportive connections. We have true love. We have cornucopia, and we also have anxiety. Let me move you over just a little bit. I don't know why this angle is so weird. Okay, Taurus. So right off the bat, as new opportunities to meet people, romantically especially, come into your life, it's important that you don't operate from a place of anxiety or from a place of fear, because you could be pushing off everything that you've been asking for, especially if you've been clearly asking the universe for genuine love, genuine people to come into your life. This isn't the time to be in opposition towards those very opportunities that are literally coming into your life to make this happen. Same thing in terms of career. There are certain goals that you have, especially for my creatives watching this, where you can make it happen, but maybe you've been in a space of anxiety when it comes to collaborating or working with other people. Whether that's not trusting that it will go good, maybe anxiousness around whether or not you'll actually succeed. Okay, imposter syndrome could be coming up for you, but it's important you don't lead with this anxiety. Move with it. Don't let it debilitate you, but don't let it make decisions and, you know, try to help you navigate your situation when you could be making decisions from more of a fearful place. Interesting. Okay, let's keep going. What are the messages for my Taurus they really need to hear from the spirit guides? Okay, so you do have good luck. And a lot of you could have a literal talisman, like maybe you had a family passed down ring or piece of jewelry or hairbrush or something like that. And this could be like your good luck charm. If you do have anything important to do, definitely make sure you bring that along with you, so that you can definitely use it and use it as some sort of like support. Okay, we also have gratitude. I kind of was getting that same thing with cornucopia. It's important that you're being in a space of literal gratitude for what you do have. Everything doesn't have to be perfect. Everything doesn't have to be, you know, laid out. And money and all of those things don't have to be together in order for you to be in a space of gratitude. You actually amplify all of the areas in your life when you express gratitude for the things that you do have. Excuse me. A lot of you also, maybe you feel taken advantage of or underappreciated, and you gotta go to spaces where you feel appreciated. Or you're going to constantly feel like you shouldn't have friends or you shouldn't have certain relationships in your life because you're not being appreciated. You're not being seen. So go where you are being seen is also the message. We also have air. So communication, clear communication, good communication is going to be key with all of your relationships, especially when it comes to love. Good communication looks like active listening. Listening more than speaking, and staying away from insults, staying away from name calling, staying away from shaming or making accusations. Only speaking from a place of what we feel, not what we feel like we know to be true. And this is how we communicate effectively. And if you are dealing with anybody who does not know how to communicate effectively and their name calling and their, you know, evading responsibility and just not receptive, it's important that you don't try to force conversations when someone's not ready. Okay, let's keep going. Also, be mindful of the quality of your thoughts during this time frame. Are you entertaining certain thoughts that could be helpful or hurtful? Okay, so we have the Strength card and also the Magic Stream. So it's important to know how much literal strength you have for certain people, certain situations, and where you feel like you need to tap out or you just don't have the room or the space to continue certain things in your life. It's important that you decide to say enough and put that boundary in place. Some of you have been letting, sorry, I'm trying to get these cards off the floor. Some of you have been letting certain issues carry on for way too long to where it's been stifling you or keeping you stuck. Okay, there's also a time where you want to be mindful of your health as well. Are you taking really good care of your mental health, emotional health, physical health? Okay, this is the time for you to get some rest, get you some proper nutrition. Okay, also making sure you're not overworking yourself to a point to where you're just energetically drained. Okay, finding ways to replenish your energy. Also with the Magic Stream, this is making sure you're not fighting against change or fighting against your personal growth just out of being uncomfortable with the emotions that you're feeling. Okay, this is a time where you need to put the effort in reestablishing yourself in terms of this new space. This is also allowing yourself to try new things. Instead of going into this space and being like, oh, I give up. Maybe try a new approach. But these are some of the things that I'm seeing. I hope that this was helpful and to give you insight in terms of what your spiritual team wants you to hear. If you did enjoy, definitely thumbs up the video, subscribe so you never miss a beat whenever I upload. I will be trying to upload a lot more for you guys in the future, so definitely stay tuned. And I will see you in the next one.